In this video, we'll be going over the spot color adjustment tool. First, let's talk about why we'd want to use that tool. That tool is good for taking spot colors and matching them to make sure they match your PMS book. Or you could actually take your colors off book if you needed to match to a previously printed sample that wasn't quite where it needed to be. You can also use, if a customer used the coded version of a PMS file, but they're actually printing on an uncoded sheet, that CMYK mix will not be correct. The software has the Pantone library built into it. So if you name your colors, say Pantone, the number, and then the suffix, we'll give you Pantone's recommended mix for that color. And like I said, if they use the coded version of a PMS color and they're going to print on an uncoded sheet, that number will be incorrect. So we'll have to adjust that so that it prints correctly on that sheet. So the first thing I'm going to do is take a file with spot colors in it. I'm going to drag and drop it right on my workflow here. And you see I've got a spot color adjustment workflow icon there and a pause. And it's going to get here and it's going to pause. Now you'll see these icons in the toolbar and right here are the same. When I select a file that's got a spot color in it, that icon highlights and now becomes a button that I can press. So when I press that button, it's going to show me the Pantone colors or spot colors that are in this job. And earlier when I mentioned if they name them this way, like the Pantone book, we'll give you Pantone's recommended mix. So we've got a couple different ways that we can alter these files. We can alter them by typing in specific numbers if we feel we can figure out what it needs to be. And I can do the same thing with the sliders here. I can move the sliders to affect the color and then print a sample out and keep doing that until I feel I'm as close as I can get. What we recommend is you use the Swatch Sheet functionality. And that's right here. And if I select that, this window right here pops up. And this is the recommended mix right here that we start with. And I can take and choose the amount of percentage I'm going to step my colors in. So you'll see that I've got like a cyan here is 45, then we go to 55, then we go to 65, and my magenta starts at 34, goes to 44, goes to 54. Now, I always like to use the two most dominant colors, but I could also, right here on my axis, I could change that color to black and yellow. Now there's no black in this color, so it wouldn't make much sense, hardly any black in it to use that, which is why cyan and magenta for this particular color is what I would want to use. But you can change those based on what you feel you need to do. What we were going to do now is we're going to actually print this out on the printer, on the media that we're going to print it on. And then we can figure out, either using the Pantone book or, like I said, a previously printed sample, and we can decide which one of these colors is getting us closer to that color that we want to hit. Now down here, this is where I'm going to tell it what I'm printing on. If I'm going to print an 8.5 by 11, I'll choose this icon. If I'm going to print a portrait style envelope feeding on the short edge, I'm going to print there. And if I'm going to print horizontal, I'll print it there. I'm going to print this on 8.5 by 11. I'm going to print the swatch sheet and say okay. And it actually sent that to the printer. It's going to print on this media. And then this is what it looks like here. Okay. So we've got that printed out. Now I'm going to look at it, choose which color I want it to be. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and, for the sake of argument, I'm going to say this color here is closest to what I'm trying to hit. And if I select it, it now pops to the center here. Now everything's going off of this mix right here. I can now change this steps to say 5%, kind of dial it in a little closer. I would print swatch sheet again, get that printed off the printer. I would then look at it and say, I think that's closest right there. I want to make sure I select it so it pops to the center here. And I can actually go down as close as 0.5%. Although, generally speaking, I think 2% is pretty close, but that depends on your clients and how you guys want to run what you're doing. I'll print it one more time just to be sure. Get a good mix of what I've got here. And I want to make sure, above all else, that when I choose the color I want it to be, I've got to select that circle. If I select that circle, it pops to the center, hit apply. That is my new mix for this printer on this paper. It's important to understand that on this paper, this media, that's the color, that's the mix to hit this color. Now, I've got a couple choices here. I could do the next color, of course, but I could also say I only want to apply this color adjustment just to this job. After this, forget about it. I don't want to use it anymore. Or I could save a color edit. Okay, hit this plus button. I can create a file that will save this color edit. And it's important, in my opinion, to name this by the color because the paper is what's going to affect the color. Not so much the customer. The paper, whether it's plain paper or a commercial envelope or a gloss paper, that's what's going to affect your color more than anything else. So I'll go ahead and just call it gloss. Hit OK. Now I've got that edit. I can hit OK. And it's actually going to do the work now. Okay. So what I can do now, basically, is show you a couple different ways we can use that spot color edit table that I've created. I'm going to go ahead and redrop this job into this workflow to erase what I've done. Okay. And if I edit the workflow by selecting this icon, the pencil icon, I can come to the spot color adjustment. All right. I can choose the set I want to use, hit the pencil to stop it again. And then if I drop a job on there, if I select it and hit the icon, you see it added that immediately. So then I could go through this and go, okay, so I've done that color, but I have not done this color. So I can go ahead, choose that, do my swatch sheet, go through that color again, make sure that color is where I want it to be. And if I hit OK and this is highlighted, it adds that color into that edit table. So now the next time I go to this job, I don't have to do that color again. Now both of those colors are saved into that table. Another way I can do this is if I don't want to put it here. Let me start over on that job. All right, I can select the job, hit the spot color icon. I could do the same thing here. And say, okay, now that one's been done. Now let me do this one, add it to that table, and we're good to go. So let's go ahead and show you what it looks like when I complete this job from start to finish. If I start this job here, and I'm just going to go ahead and let it print the way it is now. And then I'm going to go back into the spot color adjustment on it, and I'll show you what it looks like after I've done my spot color adjustment. So we've already done the one color. So let's do this color. So the same thing, swatch sheet. I want to go to 10% differences. Look at my colors. What's my two most dominant colors? Again, it's cyan and magenta on this one. All right, let's go ahead and change that color there. Okay, we print it out. Let's go to 5% increments. I'm going to go ahead and just make it a lot different than it was. Hit apply. Hit OK. And I'm going to go ahead and print this one out, and then I'll show you the difference between the two. Okay, so you see the difference between the two printouts. The original was more gray and blue, and the second one is more greenish. So that's how we use the spot color adjustment tool.